Greetings. Praise the one true God of Abraham, Yahweh, who has given his word by the prophets. It is a humbling thing when the one true God has to rub your nose in the truth to get you to see it. But then providing the answer before the question is even asked is just what God does. Let's talk about God's answer to the like Moses jihad. First, a brief history for any first-time viewers who may not have heard this before. Muhammad claimed to be a prophet. Muhammad created credentials for himself by claiming he was foretold in the Bible. Surah 7:157, those who follow the messenger, the unlettered prophet, whom they find written down with them in the Torah and the Gospel. Unlettered means illiterate, or cannot read nor write. So Surah 7:157 claims Muhammad is described as an illiterate prophet in two places, the Torah and New Testament, and claims mention could be found in the Torah and Bibles with them, meaning during Muhammad's lifetime. So Muhammad claimed he was described in two places, the Torah and the Gospel, meaning the New Testament. But wait, there's still more! Surah 7:158. So, believe in Allah and His Messenger, the unlettered prophet. So Muhammad doubles down and twice mentions the description he says you can find about him. An unlettered or illiterate prophet who cannot read nor write. But wait, there's still more! Surah 61:6. Remember when Jesus, son of Mary, said, O children of Israel, I am sent to you by Allah, confirming the Torah that came before me, and bringing good news of a messenger to follow me, whose name will be Ahmad. Yet when he came to them with clear signs, they said, this is merely sorcery. That's three claims by Muhammad, three swings at easy to prove or easy to refute claims. And during Muhammad's life, his followers never checked. But a problem arose when more Muslims gained literacy and had a thought. Christians and Jews refused to submit to Muhammad in Islam. But the Quran says that Muhammad is mentioned in their scriptures, the Torah and Gospel. If the Jews and Christians believe their scriptures and Muhammad is mentioned as the Quran says, they, the Jews and Christians, must submit to Muhammad in Islam. First, Muslims looked but could not find any such mention. So Muslims had to excuse the missing description the Quran said was there. What followed was an eternal fool's errand, looking for proof that a lie was the truth. Islam began an unending jihad to find any text, not just in the Torah or Gospel, to claim as a reference to Muhammad. Two such claims attempt to twist Deuteronomy 18 and Deuteronomy 34:10, claiming they must mean Muhammad. Let's first look how Islam tries to claim that Muhammad is the prophet of Deuteronomy 18. There are actually two parallel prophecies of a prophet to Israel given in chapter 18, Deuteronomy 18:15 and Deuteronomy 18:18. First, Moses prophesies in Deuteronomy 18:15, the Lord your God will raise up for you, meaning Israel, that's who he's talking to, a prophet like me from among your own brothers. You must listen to him. Then Yahweh God confirms in Deuteronomy 18:18, I will raise up for them a prophet like you from among their brothers. I will put my words in his mouth, and he will teach them everything I command him. I have never heard someone submitted to Muhammad quote chapter 18, verse 15. I will not focus on why that is in this video, but I will read both. The other passage that is also used in the jihad by Islam is Deuteronomy 34:10. Deuteronomy 34:10. No prophet has arisen again in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. Let us now examine how these are used in Islam's jihad to stuff Muhammad with credentials. The first desperate jihad is to claim the term brothers means descendants of Ishmael. Deuteronomy 18:15, the Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet like me from among your own brothers. You must listen to him. The desperate jihad is to try and redefine brothers to defend the claim a prophet came through Ishmael. I have several videos proving the term brothers means within the 12 tribes of Israel, so I will not repeat that here. The second desperate jihad is typical Islamic ambiguity whoring. But Islamic teachers who spread this do not think it is ambiguity they desperately hide behind. They think it is clear, perfect truth to twist two words to shoehorn Muhammad into the Torah. Like me. The Lord your God will raise up for you a prophet. Like me. Moses. From among your own brothers. You must listen to him. That was Moses speaking. And God subsequently confirms exactly what Moses said. I will raise up a prophet from among their countrymen like you. And I will put my words in his mouth, and he will speak to them all that I command him. This is Yahweh, God, talking. There is no doubt. When Yahweh, God, says, like you, God means like Moses. And because the term like may be defined by whoever is attempting to use it, it can be hard to convince a Muslim what the real meaning of like Moses is. Islam craves and yearns and struggles to define like to fit Muhammad. Carefully crafted grocery lists are created in this vain and pointless jihad against the truth. For example, rejected by his people and then accepted. Moses, yes. Jesus, no. Muhammad, yes. See, Moses and Muhammad are just like each other. Became a national leader. Moses, yes. Muhammad, yes. Jesus, not so much. Miraculous birth. Moses, no. Muhammad, no. Jesus, yes. Very miraculous birth, but different. Encountered enemies in battle. Moses, yes. Muhammad, yes. Jesus, nah, he was a lover, not a fighter. Family, married with children. Moses, yes. I don't remember reading much about his kids. They probably didn't go to college. Muhammad, yes. Jesus, no. And Muslims think the longer their list, the stronger their argument is. But notice, every list item will be carefully schemed to make Muhammad appear to fit the criterion like Moses does. You must expect no less from the religion of lies, deceit, scheming, and taqiyya. And Muslims do think the longer their list, the stronger their argument is. And it is tedious and too time-consuming to dispute such intellectually bankrupt arguments. But wouldn't it be better to be able to prove without any doubt what like Moses means? Maybe some of you already know where this is going. Hold that thought. A third jihad strategy that Islam employs is to badly misread Deuteronomy 34:10. So let us examine and understand the jihad and error that attempts to use Deuteronomy 34:10. Islam hopes desperately to disqualify Jesus with its invention. Because before you can be convinced of a lie, you must first let go of the truth. So the requisite goal Islam must accomplish is disprove the truth that the prophet is Yeshua, the Messiah. Let's see how they hope to accomplish that. Deuteronomy 34:10. No prophet has arisen again in Israel like Moses. No prophet has risen again, so no repeat, in Israel like Moses. And those who wage this jihad claim this means ever. Never ever was there another prophet like Moses. So if there was never ever another prophet like Moses in Israel, Jesus cannot be the prophet. The problem is that this jihad is firmly founded on an inability to read and comprehend. This verse speaks only of a certain time window. From the time Moses wrote Deuteronomy 18 until Deuteronomy 34 was written. And this fails to disqualify Jesus because he lived many hundreds of years after Deuteronomy 34 was written. I don't honestly know if jihadis who spread this actually key off of the phrase like Moses. But the reason Islam tries this jihad is the following logic. No prophet like Moses ever came from Israel again. To disqualify Jesus, Islam must argue Jesus is not like Moses, because clearly Jesus was a prophet and Jesus was from Israel. Jesus was a prophet and Jesus was from Israel, but must not be like Moses. So Jesus cannot be the prophet like Moses. That perfectly describes the caliber of Islamic thinking behind this jihad. But so often the argument is made regarding only the time window, that no one ever bothers to look at the rest of the story in Deuteronomy 34:10. No prophet has arisen again in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. Uh-oh. Did you catch that? The second jihad tortures the phrase, like Moses. Because Islamic teachers think they can twist like Moses to mean what they want. But Yahweh God has already given the definition. No prophet has arisen again in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. Like Moses, who Yahweh God knew face to face. Maybe y'all be knowing that stuff forever already. But for me, that was giggling good news. Jihad number 3 slays jihad number 2 in devastating clarity for those with eyes to see. Like Moses means knowing Yahweh God face to face. So did Muhammad know Allah face to face, brother? This is what Yahweh God says in Deuteronomy 34. Of the prophet in Deuteronomy 18. The prophet of Deuteronomy 18 knew Yahweh God face to face. So did Muhammad know Allah face to face, brother? Did Allah descend into his creation to meet Muhammad face to face? Did Allah take on flesh so Muhammad had a face to meet, face to face? I, for one, think Deuteronomy 34:10 rules out Muhammad and his Allah. I think, perhaps, the Son of God just might know his Father on a face-to-face basis. No prophet has arisen again in Israel like Moses, whom the Lord knew face to face. Jesus knew God face to face for eternity. I think the like Moses jihad just had its head cut off by the sword of the Word of God. Thank you, God, for answering Islam's jihad over 3,200 years before Satan's scheme. Like Moses means knowing Yahweh God face to face. And now you know the rest of the story. Good day. May the Spirit of God open your eyes to the light, your ears to the truth, and your heart to His Son, the Lord Jesus Christ. Amen.